copyrighted program created by Rio Grande.
San Francisco police calling all cars, attention all cars, broadcast 194 regarding a narcotic smuggler. Suspect described as Chinese, known as Lim Bok Young. Also as Q.L. Lee. Be on the lookout for this man. That's all.
Miles can't be wrong. You can understand how an individual might drive a few hundred miles, or a group of individuals might run up a few thousand miles with a certain brand of fuel without proving anything to themselves or others. But when 30 of the leading cities and counties of California specify a certain brand of gasoline for their police cars, fire engines, and ambulances, and that emergency equipment is driven over 55 million miles, as was the case last year, that, friends, proves that the gasoline in question, Rio Grande cracked gasoline, has what it takes. And we all know what it takes. As quick starting as a 100-yard dash, a gas that hits its stride with whirlwind acceleration, and one that has both the staying power and speed for a winning performance. You may have observed that the same Rio Grande tank trucks which service the police and fire department garages in your locality also supply your independent Rio Grande station. The same Rio Grande crack that will take police cars, fire engines, ambulances, and other emergency equipment over many millions of punishing miles again this year is available to you at no extra cost. Pull in tomorrow morning for a tank full of Rio Grande cracked gasoline that will give you police car performance. Rio Grande cracked gasoline will take your car farther and faster with less hardship to your motor or your purse. Our pleasure to present Chief Walker, head of the state's Narcotic Enforcement Division, speaking from San Francisco.
The trend of detective stories turned out by volumes each year is always toward the solution of cases by fantastic and ultra-scientific methods. In fact, the public has become so accustomed to having its detective stories solved in this way that the solution of a baffling case through the persistent use of good common sense has come to appear commonplace. Narcotic smuggling cases always carry a glamorous air of mystery for the average person, but we in this department know that it is usually a lot of good hard work that solves the case. Tonight's story is a case in point. It took weeks of patient effort and even personal danger to capture the criminal involved. What happened to him after we did catch him, you will hear as the story unfolds.
On a cold, dreary day in January, Chief Walker of the State Narcotic Division sat talking to an associate.
This case shows promise of being one that's going to require some real work, Norbeck.
Well, what are your plans, Chief?
We suspect a Chinese who calls himself Lim Bok Young. Sometimes he bobs up as QLE. But we're reasonably sure he's in the dope racket here. We've got to get the goods on him.
That should be easy.
Yeah, not as easy as it sounds. He's pretty shrewd.
Where does he hang out?
He has a real estate and insurance office down on Montgomery Street.
That sounds legitimate.
That's what it's supposed to sound like. We happen to know that he has too much money to spend and is seen in too many expensive places to be merely a small-time broker.
Lots of nightlife, huh?
Yeah, too much. He always drives a good car and usually has a girlfriend or two with him. He maintains a couple of good apartments and generally lives much better than a man of his station should.
Well, that's no reason to suspect him of selling dope.
That's not the only reason we suspect him. We've been watching him for several months and we've a pretty good idea what he's doing. But we've got to catch him with the goods on him.
We can do that, all right.
Maybe we can. So far, we haven't.
What do you think is the best angle to work?
Well, we've got to get into his confidence some way. That's what I want you to do.
You know anything about his habits? Socially, I mean.
He hangs out a great deal in the pool room near his office. He has an obsession for playing pool and for taking pictures of himself. Always has a camera and gets his friends to take the pictures.
Well, that's one way we might work. I can make a contact in one of those complexes, eh?
I don't care how you do it, but I want you to gain his confidence. Get in with him any way you want to. But we've got to get him with the dope on him.
If he's handling dope, I'll find it out. And I'll find it on him.
That's what I thought when I sent for you. Now get busy and be careful about coming back here till you've got something to work on.
Acting on Chief Walker's instruction, Norbeck strikes up an acquaintance with Young.
Pardon me. Would you mind if I got a picture of that shot?
Why, no, of course not. How is this?
Oh, that's swell. Now, hold it. That's perfect.
Do you do much camera work?
Oh, a little. I try to sell a few action shots now and then.
I have some very good short focus shots of pool and billiard balls.
That's so? I'd like to see them sometime. I'm interested in the short focus stuff.
Oh, drop by my office sometime. I'll show you my collection.
Fine, I'd like to.
Yes, yes. Here, my card. Best is on it.
I see. 604 Montgomery Street.
Yes. Oh, I see you use Leica.
Yep.
I prefer contact.
So do I. There's a little out of my class. As a matter of fact, this is all I've been able to hang on to, sort of salvage, you know.
Oh, I see. So sorry.
Okay.
Would you like to shoot game or two?
Yes, I would. I'm sort of rusty, though.
Oh, you'll pick it up again. Very easy. Boy, rack again, Walt, please.
Yes, sir.
Will you break?
After you.
Thank you.
4, 5, 7, 9, 15. Nice break. Well, let's see if I can play that 8 ball into the side pocket and kiss the 6 into the corner. That's so good.
1 and 2 in the right corner.
1 and 2. 4. Well, that's a swell shot.
3 in the side. 4 in corner. 5 inside. 6 in corner. 8 inside. And,
no. Too bad, but it's about time I got a chance. I'll try that 8. Oh, missed.
A good try. Now, let's see. I believe we can bank some cushion there on that one. Now, there she is. Now, the 10, 11, and, your turn.
12 in the corner.
Nice shooting.
13 in the side. Oh, boy, my luck's rotten tonight.
Perhaps not. Where do you work?
Well, that's just it. I don't. I'm looking for a job. I used to be a court reporter, but I lost out on that. Wasn't fast enough, I guess. I've been up at the Hall of Justice all day.
Hall of Justice?
Yeah, trying to see a friend of mine who promised to help me out on a case that he's working on.
Oh, do you know many of the people up there?
Oh, yes, quite a few. Working around there so long, you know.
Yeah, I see. How would you like to work for me?
Well, what doing?
I have a lot of work in my business. Real estate and insurance.
Oh, I see.
I do not write English so well. Perhaps we could be of benefit to each other and with your Hall of Justice contact.
Well, if you think I could do the job you have in mind...
I'm sure you can. Come in tomorrow morning.
Okay.
I pay you $35 a week.
$35?
Enough?
Maybe. I'll be there bright and early.
Come on into my office. I've got some important letters to write.
Okay.
Close the door, please.
Close.
This letter is just between us and the man who is to receive it.
Who does it go to?
Dr. Charles Wellington Ho, Canton, China.
Okay.
On Japanese steamer Kamata Mara, which sailed for San Francisco this month, will be a number one boy... Sam Lee. Sam Lee will come into your office and
we will present a letter of introduction. Are you the man this letter refers to?
Oh, yeah.
Do you know what you are to do?
I have been told to get my instruction from you.
Very well. According to this letter, you will receive the material from our representative here and take it with you on your return trip.
Oh. What form will it be in?
Same as before. The cotton light fraud may be easily packed. It is bulky, but it may be pressed into flat packages. You will conceal them on the ship. And when you arrive in San Francisco, a man will meet you and receive the packages from you.
Yeah, but how will I know this man?
He will identify himself by placing his left hand to his left ear, like this. You will place your right hand to your right ear and reply in this manner.
Is that the only identification?
No. In this letter comes this half of a photograph. It is that of an American motion picture star. You ought to take it with you. And when you meet the representative of Mr. Young, he will have the remainder of the page. You will compare them.
Oh, if he don't come to meet me?
You are to do nothing. Leave the packages hidden until you return here.
According to the letter that Young wrote to a Dr. Ho in Canton, a shipment of dope is to be brought in by a mess boy aboard the Kamata Maru next week.
Mm-hmm. And who's going to meet the mess boy?
I haven't found out yet. I have a sneaking suspicion that I'm going to be approached to act as contact man.
Well, after all, you're his private secretary.
There's no reason for my getting this stuff. However, Young's pretty sly. He won't take any more chances than are necessary.
It's a cinch you won't have any trouble getting the stuff ashore if you get it.
I still haven't found a way to catch Young with the goods on him.
We'll nab him when you deliver the stuff.
What if he doesn't send me?
Well, that's a chance we'll have to take.
And how about the customs man?
I'll call them and ask them not to stop you when you bring junk off the boat. We hope to pin a 25-year sentence on this big shot.
Chief Walker had reasoned, Young made Norbeck a proposition to go aboard the Kamata Maru and bring the drugs ashore. He argued that he was too well known by the customs man to make the attempt himself. Accordingly, arrangements were completed, and after notifying Chief Walker, Norbeck drove to the dock.
There he is, that mess boy on right. Give him signal.
There she goes. Left hand to left ear.
He is giving reply.
Yep. Right hand, right ear. Well, here goes again. You, family?
Yeah. Me only shame, number one messy boy. No savvy English, maybe.
Maybe you savvy pictures better. Here, take a look at this.
Oh, I pretty picture I like. You like a sea state alone?
Yes.
Yeah, you come this way, please.
I didn't think you spoke English.
Others on this boat do not know that. I do. And that way I learn many things.
I see. Well, here's the picture.
Thank you. Yes, Matthew, you are the representative of Mr. Young.
Yes. Young felt safer at his office.
That's why. Very well. Remove your clothing.
What?
The clothes. Coat, shirt. I have to conceal the packages.
Oh, sure.
I have them here behind the back, sir.
How many are there?
13 in all.
How are you going to hide 13 packages of dope on me?
That is my problem. It's a safe.
It's a funny way to pack this stuff.
Innocent-looking manila envelopes, aren't they?
Yeah, innocent enough. What are you going to fasten the said envelopes to?
To you.
Huh?
With this tape. First one here.
Hey, your hands are cold.
Another here. Hmm. Here. Hmm. And here.
I'm beginning to look like a brown-skinned Santa Claus.
Well, let's see. That takes care of 9 envelopes. I think you can fasten the remainder to your leg.
Yeah, we'd be lucky if I can get into my clothes with all this stuff on me.
It's soft as cotton. Press down.
I still feel like a stuffed toad.
Light, is it not?
Oh, yes, it's light enough. What is it?
Morphine. The new kind. The Manchuco.
This stuff isn't sold in this form, is it?
Oh, no. It's too expensive for that. Must be mixed with other and inferior narcotics.
Well,
Yes, I'm ready to go.
I hope none of your friends notice your increased dress.
I do look a little fat, don't I?
A little.
Well, so long. I'll be seeing you. Hello?
Steve, this is Young.
Yes, sir?
You get those envelopes.
Sure. I've got them here at my place. Just as you told me.
That's fine. Put them away where they'll be safe. Bring them down with you in the morning.
Yes, sir.
And by the way, Steve.
Yes?
You can sleep late in the morning. Come in about 11.
Thanks a lot, Mr. Young. I'll do that.
Yes. See you in the morning, then.
In the morning. Underhill 8700.
Narcotic enforcement.
Chief Walker, please.
Hello.
Hello, Chief.
Yes.
Norbeck.
Yeah?
I got the stuff this afternoon. It's here at my place.
What did Young say to do with it?
He wants me to be at the office at 11 o'clock tomorrow.
With the junk?
Yeah.
Don't do it.
What's up?
He's got an old Chinese sitting in the office to take the rep when we walk in.
Well, what do you want me to do?
Stall him along until we can get Young with the junk on him.
That's not going to be so easy.
Well, I don't care how you do it, but don't take that stuff to the office. We want Young, not that old bird he's got planted there.
Okay. I'll call him now and call you back later. Sutter, 8331.
Lim Young speaking.
Mr. Young, this is Steve.
What's the matter?
My aunt has just been taken violently ill, and I'm afraid I won't be able to get to the office in the morning unless she's better.
Oh, that is all right, Steve. If you can't come down, I'll run by your place.
Fine.
Maybe that would be better anyway.
Yes.
Suppose I come by about 9 o'clock? That is all right.
Yes, that's fine. I'll be expecting you about 9.
Yes, 9.
Underhill 8700.
Narcotic Enforcement Division.
Chief Walker.
Walker.
I just talked to Young. He's coming by my place at 9 tonight.
Fine. Now listen. You go to the car with him. If he's got the stuff on him, drop your handkerchief.
Okay. And unless I drop the handkerchief, don't make the pinch.
All right. We'll be watching you.
Minutes before 9 o'clock, a long black limousine glided to a silent stop in front of the apartment building where Steve Norbeck had established himself. Swirling eddies of thick fog shrouded the figures of Chief Walker and his men, crouching in the shadows of the house across the street. The street lamps cast opalescent blobs of light. The lights of the car died disconsolately beneath the oppressive fog. Lim Bok Young made his way to Steve's apartment. Somewhere, the doorbell shouted its alarm.
How are you, Steve?
We're fine. Come on in.
How is your aunt?
Well, she's not so well. She looks pretty bad.
I'm sorry. I should not have come by. Tomorrow would do as well.
Oh, that's all right. I've got the stuff right here.
Let me look at it. Nice quality.
There's a lot of it. You want to take it all?
As a matter of fact, I don't want to take any of it.
No?
I have a friend with me. Charming girl.
Yeah.
Incidentally, it might be very embarrassing if I was stopped for questioning.
I see.
Always tomorrow, Steve. Suppose you bring it to office tomorrow?
Well, if my aunt's any better, I'll be down about 11.
Good. You do that.
I'll walk out to the car with you.
That is not necessary. Don't trouble, Sal.
Oh, no trouble at all.
Good night, Steve. See you in the morning.
Bye, Mr. Young.
Not playing drop the anchor tonight, Steve?
Why, hello, Chief. I didn't see you come up.
No, we were waiting across the street. This fog's pretty thick.
You didn't take this stuff. Had a girlfriend.
Yes, I saw her.
Wants me to bring the junk to the office tomorrow morning.
Don't do it.
No?
I happen to know that he's arranged to have that old Chinaman there again. He's supposed to take the rap if we try to grab Young. Find some way to get him to come after the stuff. Oh, let's move out of this fog.
Yes.
Let's get inside here.
Sure. I'll find some excuse, but we should have some plan worked out in advance.
Well, when he comes here, Rick, put the morphine in your car.
Yeah?
And then fix the car so it won't run smoothly.
I know. I'll yank a wire off a couple of cylinders.
Yeah, that ought to slow him up a bit.
Sure.
We don't want to take any chances when he does get the stuff.
I'll arrange to meet him a couple of blocks down the street here, and you pick him up before he gets that far.
Don't worry about us. We'll be right on his tail.
Thank you. got here in quite a hurry.
Yes. When you phoned your aunt had passed away, I thought we'd better get stuff out.
Yes, we'll have to. The maid will begin to clean up the place in a few minutes. I've got to be with my
folks, so. Tell you what you do. You put the stuff in your car, leave the key with manager downstairs. I get the key and meet you somewhere.
Why not pick me up a couple of blocks down the street, eh?
Very well. I'll pick you up in about 10 minutes.
Fine.
Hey, Steve, you left wrong keys to car.
Let's see. No, those are my keys.
Well, I could not get car door unlocked.
Well, I'll go back with you and see what's wrong.
Did you put all the envelopes in car?
Yes, 13 of them.
We're going to make a lot of money out of this stuff.
If we don't get caught.
What do you mean by that?
Nothing. This is just a risky proposition, that's all.
No risk at all. We have done this many times. Besides, I am always prepared for any emergency.
Yes?
I've got angles I can work.
Well, angles or no angles, I'll be glad when I get this stuff out of my hands.
You have nothing to worry about. You are safe.
Not if it's found in my car.
But if I have it with me, I'd be the one to take the risk.
Well, here we are. Now to try those keys. Well, that's funny. I could have sworn... Oh, I see the key. Bent. Here. Wait a minute. Let me straighten this out or something. Now let's try it. There you are. And there's the stuff on the front seat.
Very well. I will see you later, Steve.
Yeah.
Think you'd better meet me at office this evening.
All right, I'll be there about 8.
As Young pulled away from the curb in Norbeck's car, another automobile nosed into view through the fog and halted momentarily beside Norbeck.
Steve, who is it? Walker, come here.
We've got the stuff. He just drove off.
Was he alone?
No, there's another Chinese with him.
Did you know him?
Well, I've seen him a time or two. His name is Mo T. Lee.
Is he in on this racket?
I don't know. I've seen him around with Young a few times.
Well, we'll assume that he is.
Well, you better get started if you're going to pick Young up.
We'll get him all right. Follow in. We'll see how far he can get in that car of yours. Any idea where he's headed for?
Well, he's going home first, I imagine. I'm to meet him at the office later.
You seen anything that looks like your car?
Not in this fog.
Well, he won't get far with the motor missing.
I took 2 ignition wires off. Sitting in only 4 cylinders.
You see him yet?
No. Hey, wait a minute. Wait. Yeah, there he is.
You think he's got a gun?
I don't think so.
Well, here goes.
Okay.
Pull over the curb.
What all this about? What have I done?
Plenty. You're under arrest for violating the state narcotic act.
Oh, there must be some mistake.
There is, and you've made it. It was a mistake to start off with that junk on your lap.
This is nothing, just a few chemicals.
Yeah, we'll find out soon enough at headquarters. Come on, get out of the car.
You'll regret this act.
I'll risk that. Come on, get out.
That chemist report yet, Steve?
Yep. Stuff is high-grade morphine. It's one of the biggest shipments of pure morphine we've picked up.
How much in all?
32 ounces of it.
All in 7x10 envelopes.
That's right. Boy, I looked stuffed when I had that junk strapped to me.
By the way, we're asking that Dr. Ho and the mess boy be picked up in Canton.
Gonna go pretty hard with them in China, won't it?
You know, that's something they're going to have to worry about.
I understand Young wants to talk to you alone.
Yeah, I have an idea he wants to make a proposition.
Well, I'll wait outside while you talk to him.
Okay. I'll send for you when I find out what he wants. Oh, tell O'Brien to send him in.
Yes, sir.
Come in, Young. Sit down.
Yes. Thank you.
I understand you want to talk to me alone.
That is right. I have got proposition to make.
Don't entertain propositions, Young.
You might be interested in this one.
What is it?
How would you like to make $1,000... very easily.
You're willing to pay me $1,000 to let you get away with smuggling $16,000 worth of morphine, huh?
Remember, I have already paid for it once.
How about the Federals?
I'm prepared to offer them the same amount.
Do you think they might be interested in your proposition?
I don't know. It's worth trying.
Yes, I rather think it is. Send O'Brien in here to get a prisoner. I am not interested in your $1,000, Young, nor in any other amount you might offer. It's taken us 8 months to catch you, and we're going to have you around for a long, long time. So long, Mr. Young. I'll be seeing you in federal prison.
The next time you stop at a railroad crossing, observe closely the myriad moving parts of the giant locomotive which momentarily blocks your path. You might give the engineer a friendly high sign as a brother under the skin, because the chances are his train belongs to one of the 150 railroads in the country which depend on Sinclair Motor Oil. You and the engineer have something in common because you have both Sinclairized for safety. Yes, 8 major airlines, 150 railroads, great fleets of ships, and millions of motorists in 45 nations of the world all depend upon Sinclair Oil for the same outstanding reason. They do not wave the white flag of surrender to even intense summer heat or to excessive speed. The patented Sinclair refining process entirely removes petroleum, jelly, and wax. That's why. Sinclair Opaline, which comes to you in tamper-proof cans at only 25 cents a quart, has proved the favorite with millions. By the way, have you seen the new August issue of Calling All Cars News? Well, if you haven't received your free copy, get it tomorrow from your Rio Grande dealer, for it features 2 baffling and authentic detective stories. An exclusive story from the pen of Leslie Howard, with an offer of personally autographed pictures, free. An array of interesting photographs, vital news, the lowdown on the high-ups of screen and radio. A helpful guide in choosing the next picture you wish to see, and numerous other features. Get your free copy at the nearest Rio Grande station, where, if you're wise, you Sinclairize for safety with Sinclair Motor Oil, and equip your car with police car performance with Rio Grande cracked gasoline. Young was lodged in the city jail in San Francisco and bail set at $25,000, later being reduced to $10,000. Young didn't appear for trial, one of the rare cases where a Chinese jumped bail, but 18 months later was arrested in China by the Chinese government. Faced with trial and possible execution in China, or return to the United States and certain imprisonment, Young elected to return to San Francisco. He is now serving a sentence of 10 years in federal prison.
Police calling all cars. Attention all cars. Cancellation broadcast 194. Suspect in this case are now in custody. That's all.
Frederick Lindsay, bidding you good night for Rio Grande.